You must have heard about the military takeover in the Republic of the Niger. Many might be inclined to dismiss this coup as just another occurrence within the wave of coups in Africa. However, it is important to delve into the historical context that has led to the recent political developments in this African nation. So let us start with the basics. Where exactly is Niger located? It is situated in West Africa. In fact, it is the largest country in West Africa. As you can see on the map, Niger is a landlocked country. It is surrounded by several other countries and does not have any coastline or direct access to the sea. This river flowing through the southwestern part of the country is the Niger River. The country Niger derives its name from this very river. Let us take a closer look at Niger's neighboring countries. To its northwest lies Algeria, while Libya is situated to the northeast. Moving eastward, you will find Chad, and to the south is Nigeria. The southwestern neighbors include Benin and Burkina Faso, while Mali shares its western border. The capital of Niger is Niamey. Niger holds membership in various international groupings, including the United Nations, the African Union, and the Organization of Islamic Cooperation. Discussing the religious facet, more than 99% people in Niger follow Islam, with Sunni Islam being the predominant branch. Talking about the ethnicity aspect, Niger's primary ethnic group is Hausa, followed by Zama and Songhe, with Tuareg coming next in line. Niger's ousted President Mohamed Bazoum belongs to the ethnic Arab minority. At times, he was characterized as having a foreign lineage.
All right, having established our groundwork, let's now delve into gaining a comprehensive understanding of the ongoing situation in Niger. Meanwhile, uncovering the elements that have contributed to the nation's current state. As we examine the landscape, it becomes evident that the presence of abundant resources and its strategic importance has rendered African nations as arenas for the engagement of global powers. Put simply, Africa has been the battleground of global powers. We cannot overlook the historical injustices that were imposed by colonizers, who were propelled by an unquenchable thirst for control and supremacy. Driven by their imperial ambitions and the pursuit of economic opportunities within Africa, the European powers partitioned the continent among themselves. This evil episode is commonly known as the Scramble for Africa. Now, why is it of utmost significance to talk about this piece of history? Because it contains the very foundational origins of the contemporary challenges faced by Africa. The predicaments that presently grip the continent trace back to the unjust actions executed by the colonizers.
Motivated by the desire to exploit Africa's plentiful resources, such as minerals, land, and labor, the colonial powers etched arbitrary borders onto the African map. Their objective was to assert easier control over the land and its people. In the process, they displayed a complete disregard for the diverse ethnicities, cultures, and languages that thrived across the continent. Instead, they constructed borders guided solely by their own interests. This is the reason behind the presence of the distinctive straight lines that you see on the African map. These artificially imposed boundaries stirred up ethnic and cultural tensions, compelling various groups to coexist within the confines of these delineations. This malevolent arrangement has often ignited conflicts and competitions for power and resources, the echoes of which continue to resonate across the continent. Thus, the colonial legacy has significantly sculpted Africa's socio-political landscape.
Now, Niger was a French colony. During its colonial era, the government employed brutal methods to suppress the local political institutions and culture of the country. Niger gained independence in 1960. The power vacuum that emerged post-independence facilitated military leaders to take control. Consequently, over the years following its independence, Niger's journey has been marked by a series of military coups and periods of political instability. These coups stemmed from complex factors such as power struggles, economic challenges, and disagreements within the ruling elite. C. Independent nations typically confront the formidable challenge of constructing robust institutions and establishing a steady political framework. And achieving this necessitates a foundation of political stability. But when leadership keeps changing frequently, this task becomes quite a puzzle. And Niger has had its fair share of this puzzle. Political instability in the country has hampered economic growth, discouraged foreign investment, and even created tensions among various ethnic and political groups.
Presently, Niger stands among the world's most impoverished nations, grappling with a substantial illiteracy rate. The country is plagued by poverty, food insecurity, and an overall lack of development. Another thing is that Niger boasts substantial natural resources, most importantly gold and uranium. In fact, Niger ranks as the world's 7th largest producer of uranium and possesses the highest grade uranium ores in Africa. And therefore, even after Niger's liberation from French colonial rule, France has retained a notable sway over the nation's political and economic terrain. Around 70% of France's energy is sourced from nuclear power, and the nation significantly relies on importing uranium from Niger. French corporations play substantial roles in Niger's critical sectors like energy, mining, and infrastructure. Ongoing concerns frequently revolve around the uneven extraction of resources and the unjust distribution of benefits within Niger. France wields considerable economic influence over multiple African nations, including Niger.
The mismanagement of the economy in the country created a fertile environment for the occurrence of a coup. The economic partnership between France and Niger exhibited a clear imbalance, disproportionately favoring France. This reinforced the voices portraying Niger as an extension of the French quasi-empire within the African continent. This dynamic fostered perceptions that Niger's democratically elected leader, President Mohamed Bazoum, was in essence a French puppet leader. In the latest developments, Bazoum has been ousted from power. The military junta has stepped in and taken control. A military junta is basically a group of military leaders who have taken over the government by force. This transfer of power has resulted in General Abdurrahmane Chiani assuming the responsibility of overseeing the transitional government. Ironically, General Chiani held the role of supervising the presidential guard, charged with the crucial duty of protecting the president from situations like the present military takeover. Reports indicate that Bazoum tried to push Chiani into retirement. However, Chiani removed Bazoum from power instead. Obviously, France has cut off aid following the coup.
At this juncture, I would like to introduce the Sahel region into our discussion. I'm sure you would have heard about the Sahara Desert. It is the largest desert in the world. Over 80% of Niger's land area lies in the Sahara Desert. As a desert, this region experiences arid conditions. Now look here down south. You would find a belt of lush savannas here. In between the arid Sahara Desert and this belt of humid savannas lies a transitional zone. This intermediary area, stretching from the Atlantic Ocean to the Red Sea, is known as the Sahel region. Extending from Senegal in the west to Sudan in the east, this belt spans approximately 5,400 kilometers in length and up to 1,000 kilometers in width. Characterized by an unforgiving, dry climate, this region frequently grapples with water scarcity. This scarcity presents a significant challenge, particularly considering Niger's heavy reliance on water-intensive sectors such as agriculture, livestock, and mining. Further, the region's rapidly growing population, driven by high birth rates, exacerbates the situation. In fact, the nation we are presently discussing, Niger, has the world's highest fertility rate.
dire living conditions afflicting citizens due to the pervasive poverty and inequality heightened their vulnerability to military coups. C. When individuals perceive a lack of equitable representation or feel their economic necessities are unmet, they may incline towards supporting a military coup as a catalyst for change. This region, in fact, demonstrates a notable incidence of military coups. Mali, Burkina Faso, Sudan, and now Niger find themselves governed by military juntas. Within these nations, factors such as feeble governance, corruption, and ethnic clashes have triggered military interventions under the pretext of restoring stability. This geographic area is also recognized for insurgency, political volatility, and ethnic frictions. Terrorist groups such as Boko Haram, Islamic State, and Al-Qaeda frequently carry out attacks in this region, significantly hindering economic advancement. Further, the military juntas often justify their coups by asserting that the civilian administration lacked the capability to effectively manage the escalating terrorism and the accompanying security complexities within the country.
Within Niger, the active engagement of France, Russia, and the United States is already evident. Despite the presence of both US and French troops within its borders, the civilian leadership proved unable to quell insurgent attacks within the country. Moreover, the people perceived the presence of foreign military forces and installations on their land as an encroachment upon their sovereignty. For instance, the existence of US drone bases in the country contributed to unrest. The United States views these bases as a vital component of its counter-terrorism endeavors within the Sahel region. Anyway, when the French embassy in Niger was attacked, France issued a stern warning, emphasizing its zero-tolerance stance towards any assault on French interests. French President Macron's warning of a swift and unwavering response to those challenging the established order echoed a commanding presence, reminiscent of historical imperial authority.
Then, as part of its broader ambitions to extend its sway, Russia has steadily bolstered its military and economic presence across Africa in recent times. Russia eyes Niger's uranium reserves along with countering the influence of the United States and France in the region. An instrumental player in this endeavor is Russia's Wagner Group, the very mercenary organization that recently made an attempt to stage a coup in Russia. Russia strategically deploys the Wagner Group to expand its influence beyond its borders, particularly targeting regions of strategic, political, or financial significance. This approach allows Russia to deftly create a distinction between its own actions and those executed by the Wagner Group, thereby complicating external efforts to establish direct Russian involvement. This calculated approach empowers Russia to actively pursue specific objectives without overtly assuming responsibility. The failed coup orchestrated by the Wagner Group has further heightened the level of plausible deniability on the global stage.
By the way, Niger's military junta has sought assistance from Russia's Wagner Group, which had a pre-existing presence in Africa even before the onset of the Ukraine conflict. Some individuals hold the belief that the military aided by Wagner Group could potentially succeed in quelling insurgency. The demonstrators outside the French embassy in Niamey even waved Russian flags, underscoring the growing discontent towards Western influence in Africa. Amidst this backdrop, rival powers such as Russia and China have adroitly seized upon the escalating disenchantment with collective Western influence in Africa, leveraging the situation to their advantage.
You might be aware that ECOWAS is gearing up for an intervention in Niger. To comprehend this, we need to firstly understand what ECOWAS is. ECOWAS stands for the Economic Community of West African States. This entity represents a regional union of 15 nations situated in West Africa. However, in the aftermath of the coup, ECOWAS has suspended Niger from its membership. ECOWAS came into existence in 1975 as a result of the Lagos Treaty. Its primary aim centers around fostering both political and economic collaboration among its member countries. Within this geographical expanse, a substantial population resides. Estimates place the count at no less than 40 crore people. The primary goal of ECOWAS is the establishment of a unified currency and the creation of a cohesive trading bloc across the western reaches of Africa. Essentially, it aims to create a seamlessly integrated and boundary-free region.
ECOWAS wants the region to be guided by the principles of democracy, the rule of law, and good governance. It is noteworthy that the United States wields influence within ECOWAS. Hence, transcending the objectives of economic collaboration, ECOWAS has also endeavored to quell instances of military conflict within the region. ECOWAS has been involved in prior military interventions. And in the current situation too, ECOWAS has issued a stern warning of potential military intervention if the military junta fails to reinstate President Bazoum. However, the junta has rebuffed this proposition and gone so far as to close Niger's airspace. Adding another layer to this complex situation, Niger's neighboring countries Mali and Burkina Faso are both under military juntas. These neighbors have expressed solidarity with the military takeover in Niger, declaring an assault on Niger as tantamount to an attack on their own territories.
The situation in Niger underscores the vital importance of having strong political institutions. When political institutions are weak, they often lack the capability to effectively manage conflicts and settle disputes. This vulnerability can open the door to both domestic and foreign military interventions, leading to instability. An intriguing connection exists between instability and the emergence of military leaders. In the case of Niger, there is a significant consideration involving its uranium reserves, which play a crucial role in powering France's nuclear energy. This leads to France being strongly motivated to establish a government in Niger that aligns with its interests. And that raises concerns about the potential for a serious conflict in the region.
Recent updates highlight that ECOWAS has approved a military intervention in Niger. The objective behind this intervention is to remove the military rulers and reinstate constitutional governance in the country. ECOWAS has instructed its armed forces to be prepared for action to achieve this goal. Additionally, the United States has expressed its support for ECOWAS's strategy, aiming to restore stability to Niger. Seems like the saviors of democracy are assembling again. Prayers for the people of Niger.